Cathedral of the Madeleine is a very beautiful and important place in Salt Lake City. Many times I see people enter the cathedral, which is stone and mortar, and they all walk up the stairs, they look at all the artifacts, but then they walk in and they see a completely different experience. And they feel this experience.
Just a place of solace, a place where you can just relax and feel the Lord's Spirit.
They feel the art, they feel the music, they feel the silence that leads them to a true spirit of prayer. And that's why they leave there a changed person, because the cathedral offers them that opportunity.
Alan and I were married at the Cathedral of the Madeleine on October 24th, 1962. I met Alan on a blind date. Our first date was horrible. We went to a movie and it was a strange movie, and he sat back in his seat and put his elbow in my eye, and it hurt. And I said, Alan, so I was wondering if this was going to work out, but we persevered, and it did. So it was a lasting thing. And he finally said, I'd like to offer you a permanent job, and asked me to marry him. Alan always claimed the cathedral as his mother's parish and their parish. Alan and Nancy used to catch the bus to go for catechism, and Alan would throw the money behind a bush and say he lost it, so they couldn't go. And I don't know, my son said, why would he throw it? He could just say he threw it, he could keep the money. I said, well, he didn't want to lie.
Alan Lipman and his sister Nancy were originally from Salt Lake City. Their mother, Marion Lipman, was very involved in the cathedral parish. She was a great community organizer. And I think that's the spirit that Alan and Nancy took upon themselves. Each of them in their own way, then where they lived, did that.
We decided we're going to move to Ogden. We'll find a place. And we rented a home. And his mother had always said, you need to give back to the community. So we came and we gave back to the community, and we had our children here, raised them here. They went to the Catholic school. We volunteered at the Catholic school and did spree. He did lots of things. There is such a need for the homeless, and to see families, sometimes not of their own problem, but just circumstances, to be homeless and needing food and needing clothes and needing so much. And Alan and I decided this is what we would do. We raised enough money to build the Lantern House, which is very well used here in Ogden, and it's the only homeless shelter clear to the Idaho border.
For Alan, getting himself involved in so many different ways in Ogden was a very important part of his life.
He was very faithful. I mean, he would go to church all the time, but he just always said, we need to give back. And I think he wanted to be true to his history. He has just a very generous heart.
I think Nancy's mother and her religion really gave her the direction that she took her life in. She was on the board of the Girl Scouts for years and years. Those of us that were on the board, and then after we were on the board, she wanted to know how many cookies we bought. She was the first woman president for United Way. She accomplished things, but she did them in a very quiet, organized, acceptable way. The thing that she got the most from her religion was the feeling that she had the ability to give.
We're sitting here in this beautiful Holy Family Church, which is a true legacy to Bob Evans, Father Patrick Elliott, and the congregation. It was years in the making. The parish was founded in 1980, but the church wasn't built until 2008. So Bob Evans was very instrumental in wanting this parish to have a permanent church.
Bob and I moved to Ogden in 58. We lived for a while on 27th Street, so we went to St. Joseph's. Bob was very charismatic, and people loved being around him. Started his own company, we broke even the first year. And then from then on, he was very involved in the community. Bob was a founding member of the Catholic Foundation. He read the Bible. He really was a spiritual guy.
There are many signs that Bob Evans and his wife Mary left in this church of their prayerfulness, their confidence in the work of the Lord. The altar, which is the center of this church, but also the high window, which is always evidence of all that is yet to come.
His giving was motivated by just the joy of giving to people. Father Elliott used to say, "This is the church that Bob built."
If you translate the stone and mortar to heart and soul, analogy to the lives of Bob Evans and Nancy and Alan Lipman, we see in their lives the importance of witnessing to the gospel in their own way. And I think that's the legacy that the cathedral has now and in the years and generations to come.
The cathedral enriches our life by, it just adds more to our family, especially now with Antonio. We can kind of grow him in the church, and I think it just brings us a lot closer together.
And then if you look at 10 and 2...
The architecture and the art found within the cathedral really translate into showing faith to our community. While it is a gorgeous building, it's what the building represents. For me, that helps build my faith. When we go inside, I feel closer to God. It fills my heart with love.
You receive communion every Sunday and you have the Christ within you, and you want to take it out and share that with other people. We want to do God's work.
That's what Christ asks us to do, is to celebrate that. And we can't celebrate it just here on Sunday. It has to be as we walk out the door. You know, you have to carry that. I've never met somebody who came in here who didn't feel something special. And they're really impacted by this jewel in Salt Lake City. Thank you.